Hey guys, welcome back. So I have a product review slash demo slash comparison. The review is on the Anastasia Beverly Hills new brow definer, or somewhat new brow definer. So if you follow my channel, you know I absolutely love Brow Wiz, and there was so much hype around the brow definer. I was like, I'm just gonna have to get it and try it. So this is the brow definer, and there's definitely been a ton of hype around this product. This is the original Brow Wiz, so you can see the brow definer is definitely a lot thicker and does have a different shape to it. So this is what the new shape looks like. It's kind of a triangular, elongated. When you first open the product, it does have like a nice sharp edge to it. The only way to ever get that sharp edge back is to roll the product down until there's just a little tiny bit popped up, and kind of grind it down a little, either on the back of your hand or on a clean surface, to get that sharp edge built back up. So the biggest difference in between the Brow Definer and Brow Wiz is the shape. You do get a tiny, I mean a minute little itty bitty bit more in the definer than you do the Brow Wiz. This does retail for $23, the Brow Definer, and the Brow Wiz is $21. So I have nothing on my eyebrows right now, and you can see they're pretty thin. I wasn't blessed with like big, beautiful, full eyebrows. So I really think the person that's gonna benefit the most from Brow Definer is gonna be somebody with thicker eyebrows. Because the Brow Definer, the best thing about the Brow Definer is that you can cover more area more quickly. Brow Wiz is a lot smaller, and you can make more defined strokes with the Brow Wiz. So when you're trying to fill in your brows, it does take a little bit more time than the Brow Definer. So I have been noticing that when I'm in a hurry, I will grab for the Brow Definer, but that's pretty much just because I bought it and I have it and I would like to use it up. I don't think I'm gonna repurchase the Brow Definer because, like I said, I have thinner brows, and it's just, you know, I still have to go back in and sometimes touch up with my Brow Powder Duo or my Brow Wiz because my brows are just smaller. But I'm gonna show you how I use it. So you can see how it just really covers in any sparse areas pretty quickly. Now out here where my brow is pretty thin, I kind of turn it around on its backside to use the more pointed area. But when you use it, you see how it's like rounding out a little? And then I would have to waste product to grind it down and get that sharp edge back again. So you can see it gives you more of like a powdery look to it because it's not as precise as the Brow Wiz. So it's kind of like the same look that you would get from using the powder. And then I just go in with the spoolie and kind of blend out this area. And that's how I use the definer. So you can see it does cut down on time when you're doing your eyebrows, just because you can cover more area with the brow definer versus the Brow Wiz. So I don't hate it. I just don't love it more than the Brow Wiz. I will finish it up, but I am not gonna be repurchasing it. I feel like the person that would really benefit and like the brow definer is somebody with thicker brows and or somebody who doesn't really like that super defined look. They just like to fill in sparse areas and not look like you have in filled in brows, more of like a natural brow. So I hope you enjoyed this quick review and comparison. I thought it would be a lot of fun to do a poll. So I'm gonna link a poll here. If you've tried both of these and you prefer one over the other, definitely answer the poll and thumbs up this video if it was helpful, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.